Don't even need to introduce this level because everyone hates this stage, but for those who skipped out on one of Sonic's greatest adventures, Eggman Land is the final stage before the battle with Egg Dragoon and Dark Gaia. It is the ultimate test of skill as you switch between day and night for up to 30 to 45 minutes it takes to finish this. I am not kidding, it is the longest stage in the entire Sonic series. Throwing everything at you, such as the bobsleds, quick time event ramps, and the strongest Eggman mechs to get in your way. Not to mention all the precise platforming needed to get from A to B, as this level seems to love trying to send you off into the abyss. To make matters worse, the hot dog vendor requires you to finish this stage 3 times without dying during a time trial. At least it's only 3 times and not 9 like his co-workers. I ranted about this before, but just to summarize, it's a pain in the ass. This and Central City are open-ended levels with missions to explore and find or destroy your objectives. The problem is that there are no markers, no map, and no hints as to where the hell they are. Not even a redundant, "I sense something nearby," quip from Shadow or your partner. It's a labyrinth of redundancy as everything looks the goddamn same. And will everyone just stop shooting me? This is, of course, if you're going for the hero or dark missions. If you're just trying to find the gold ring, it's barely a 5-minute romp in the arc. I spent the better part of 35 minutes on the hero mission just to complete a specific storyline. No, it was not worth it! Do I even need to say why? The fourth zone of the first game that was originally planned to be the second? War levels do not work in Sonic's favor. Very rarely do they feel like you can actually run through them like with the other zones surrounding them. Hydrosity is the only good one. But yes, Labyrinth Zone. Take all the bad parts of Marble Zone and add water. That's a pretty good summary. It's slow, there's traps everywhere that you can barely react to, not to mention of how sparse the air bubbles seem to be. With possibly the worst and most dumbest boss battle in the entire game. You don't even need to hit Fatty Lobotnik. That tornado's carrying a car! Yeah, well, this TV has a controller lodged in it. How did this make it into Sonic Generations and be the best stage of that game? Crisis City incorporates everything wrong with the gameplay and design of Sonic 2006, and all conveniently split into 4 parts. Loading times notwithstanding. A broken snowboarding section on buildings with enemies appearing out of the freaking ground, a platform section with an awkward camera, another but in the air with levitating platforms and chains of enemies, all finally ending with the worst max speed section of the whole game. At least the loading times will give you a breather between each section, but I hope you gain plenty of lives beforehand. And to be honest, it was between this or Flame Core. At least the latter's main gripe is a shitty puzzle in the dark. I kept hearing that this was a bad stage and I thought, really? Over Tidal Tempest, over Collision Chaos, and over Metallic Madness? So I replayed it. And yeah, this stage sucks. Sonic CD's level design suffers from being too maze-like, as you're encouraged to explore it, but it really doesn't work with the game's favor when the main design of Sonic 1 and 2 is to speed through the stages ASAP. But at least a majority of the game's zones carry a forward momentum. Wacky Workbench wants to send you skyward. The majority of the floor is a freaking trampoline that sends you onto a platform you didn't want to be on. Not to mention the spinning platforms that elevate up and down that are always in your way. Throw in some electrical hazards and bad Badnik placing and you've got one hell of a mess. The fact that they expect you to travel back in time to destroy a robot transporter and a Metal Sonic projector is insane.